So now whether he'll attack disqualification, is there a serious consequence? He asked me. One by one I explained them. Step one, if you are doing any business other than a chartered accountancy, you have to get counsel's permission. Whether it's a finance business is allowed. When the finance business, the counsel will direct you not to give it to a client. So you are not obtained the counsel permission. So look at obtaining the counsel permission and see what a counsel gives a permission. Second, you are telling that you have given a money to them. Now, as per the Companies Act separately, if without looking at the IC code, you have to look at IC code only. In combination with the IC code only, you have to look at the disqualification. For appointing as an auditor, it is not disqualification. You can still appoint it. It will come as a misconduct, that's all. But looking at the appointment formality, it is not a disqualification. The loan you are providing to the company and the company is paying the interest, you are saying it is more than audit fees. Nowhere this disqualification comes. Accordingly, no need to worry from the Companies Act perspective. But from the Code of Ethics perspective, ethics perspective, I saw some of the cases where if you are doing a business, then you need to disclose to the council what business you are doing is what it says. And looking at that perspective also, you look at how do you cover yourself as a risk and then ensure that if you want to get a permission, get it, and then if it's up to you to carry out this business. Like that I told. So what you have to understand here, indebtedness is by me to the company. I have to owe the money to the company. If the company owes to me, that is not attracted here. Then indebtedness to company is covered. Then last final point, guarantee or security. Again, the indebtedness will also include your relatives. Like you are owing only 3 lakh rupees, your relative owes 2.5 lakhs, 5.5 you are owing, then what cannot be done directly under the Companies Act cannot be done indirectly. Instead of you obtaining the loan, you made your relative to obtain 2.5 lakhs and you got 3 lakhs, and in this way, you know, you cannot plan. What cannot be done directly cannot be done indirectly under the Companies Act. Finally, guarantee security in connection with the indebtedness of any third person in excess of 1 lakh rupees. And there is a third person who is dealing with the company. For the third person, for the amount of loan he has taken, I have given a guarantee or a security. Or a security in connection with the indebtedness of any third person in excess of rupees 1 lakh. Then, in excess of rupees 1 lakh, up to 1 lakh it is permitted. Then in excess of 1 lakh rupees, it is not permitted. It will call for disqualification. Now let me ask you a simple question. That indebtedness with respect to security, is it the face value or the market value? Share value. Let us assume face value or market value? Face value. Because let us assume if they are going to say market value, then there is no limit to it. They cannot freeze the market. Yeah, exactly. So they have said face value, but it is very, very less is what I say. Wipro 1 lakh rupees, how does it matter? So 1 lakh rupees share you bought before, today it will be somewhere in crores. So looking at that, very market value is not considered, only face value is considered to dilute. Next, then here, in connection with the security, guarantee of security in connection with the indebtedness of any third person in excess of 1 lakh rupees. That security value, is it the security value or is it the loan amount for which you have provided more than 1 lakh? There is some third person got loan more than 1 lakh, for him you have provided guarantee. Or is it the guarantee should exceed more than 1 lakh? Answer is the guarantee value. If the guarantee value exceeds 1 lakh, then the disqualification gets attracted. It is not the loan that is obtained by the third person. If the third person had to get 10 crore rupees loan also from the company, but if you have provided a guarantee for 1.1 lakh, also the disqualification gets attracted. This is the maximum interpretation possible in this disqualification. There is no other any possibility of having any chance of discussing on any disqualification. We have exhausted all the options under the disqualification. I am 100% sure this knowledge is not my knowledge. It is the knowledge of all the branch members. Wherever I go, when we did for the first time presentation, it was only a pure deliberation. Then the members started asking when we deliberated, the time we spent with the members, the knowledge what we carry is the members' knowledge. So these are all the cumulative knowledge of all the branches wherever we visited. Some of them told like this, some of them told like this. The joke also I told, one of the members only told me. I never thought about all those jokes. The husband and wife joke. Like that he told in one seminar, 100 people are sitting, he got up and told, like this fight comes, what to do? Like that he told. So, then, audit rotation we have discussed. Non-audit services. So we have non-audit services. I told that non-audit services we provide, prohibited services we provide. Prohibited services we provide under section 144. So any service other than the statutory audit rendered by the auditor required to be pre-approved by the board or the audit committee. Notwithstanding the above, the following services cannot be provided as an auditor. What are those services? Accounting and bookkeeping. Now, there is a dangerous point here. Very nearly, accounting, management only is responsible for preparation of books of preparation, maintenance of books of accounts and preparation of financial statement. Even under the auditor's report, we always say the management is responsible for preparation of the financial statement. Tell me one client which gives you financial. I'll tell you my own example. I completed along with the BCom, unfortunately I completed both cost accountancy and company secretary, because of which I got into one of the premium firms articleship. I expected articleship means auditor will go and they will open the car, we will go with the respect and then do the audit in a AC and then come back. So with this mind, I have to tell the realistic picture, what have happened, what is the expectation student had and what happens in the reality. When we went with the audit, that audit was dusted place, old company, and the pay fee is very less. I called the senior, I don't like this audit. Oh, you have to be given only what you like. No, you have to do is what he said. Okay, I'll do. I went to the client place, slowly I removed my tie. Then it was so suffocating that I have to remove the first button. I removed the first button. The first year college days again came back. Then I asked the client, give me the financial. What? He asked. Give me the financial statement, sir. What? He asked. You have to give me, sir, he said. Why should I give, sir? Sir, I studied in IPCC, sir. I am qualified. This and all, sir. Oh, that is in paper. You prepare and give. It is your responsibility, he says. Sir, no, sir. An audit report also like this. You see the format, sir, I have. Okay, you don't know all these things. I will call the senior. Like that, he said. So, I have not told. Mr. Y.H. Malegam, the past president of the ICI, in one of his articles, disqualified the audit report in moneycontrol.com. He has said, theoretically, the financial statement should be prepared by management. Theoretically. He has used the word called theoretically. He has not used the word called practically. Theoretically, the financial statement. He has never told who was to prepare. He has only told what is the provision. Theoretically, my senior called and showed me that article and said, underline this. And then you learn it throughout your life. Theoretically, the preparation of the financial statement, still the responsibility of the management. What happens practically, I cannot disclose. So you have to understand by understanding the context in which it is used. So preparation of the financial statement, we all know what is happening. Members are only helping the clients to prepare in most of the cases. And when you do that, it is better also, I would say. Why the client should prepare wrongly and you rectify it again and again? It is like this, to put it across. You prepare the right financial statement, ask the client what should be wrongly done, and then audit that and report in your qualified report, like this. You are preparing right financial statement, client says no, the classification is not like that, classification is differently. You are going to tell them, if it was the financial statement which I prepared, it is a right financial statement for which it will not attract qualified report. It is a clean report that I will give. Now you are saying, you please change the classification, it will attract disqualification. It will attract qualification, modification. So it is like that now. So practically what has to happen, when I revisit my CA classes, it is like this. Preparation of the financial statement should be done by the management. Then it has to be adopted by the board of directors. After board of directors have adopted, the auditor will only go and tick. That is the reason we have a tick symbol. We have tick, reverse tick. But today, ticking is not there. Preparing itself we only do. And now it has become a thumb rule that you have to go to the client place, prepare the financial statement. On a hypothetical date, the board meeting will be held. The accounts are adopted after you prepared. Then you have to sign it post that. There is no audit that happens after the board meeting. It is only the signing that happens after the board meeting. Rest of the procedures happen. This is a factual. Your theory says, board has to adopt the accounts. It says accounts. Accounts of the company. Not financial statement. Accounts of the books of accounts will be adopted. Then books of accounts includes your financial statement. Then the financial statement will be released, then the auditor should audit from that financial statement which is adopted. You have to find out the issue and then qualify. So finishing, authority, approval, everything should have happened. From there you have to give the audit report is what theoretically everything is said. Practically different things are happening. Yes sir.
I'll give you one more instance.
Yes sir.
You can increase your vocabulary.
Yes sir.
Like the husband wife word. You correct one thing for me. I've gone to one of my clients. I met the managing director. I said, sir, books of accounts. He said, wait. In his pocket, he said, what pocket? He brought two diaries. He said, one is personal, and this is the diary. I said, I want books of accounts. So this is all the payments and receipts are written over here. Okay. You prepare vouchers and books of accounts. I said, bank statements. That where are we drink from the bank? You tell me. I said, then purchase bills. These are all on small purchases. You prepare the bill. You tell the computer person. You prepare the purchase bill and sell it. Okay. And this is the diary. You prepare it. How many days you take? 7 days. After 10 days, you come to me, after the signing, I'll give you the check. This is the answer. There should be two diaries. One is personal diary.
From there, we have to take extracts. So that is how, accounting and bookkeeping. So now, we can't avoid preparing. Okay, let us assume we can't avoid. So what we can do is, procedure has to be compliant. In the letter of engagement, you are going to say only audit. In none of your mails, you will recommend a client to account. If you say you account like this, then it becomes an accounting service. There is an inconsistency between your correspondence and your agreement in the letter of engagement. While you are communicating to the client with a mail or SMS or while you are speaking, you tell the accounting standard requires, the requirement is, it is a suggested like that you have to use. Suggested, recommended like that. Don't tell you have to account like this. That should not be used as a wording in the, so mail correspondence and should match with your letter of engagement. So, because it's a prohibited service, it will call for disqualification. If you are disqualified and you have accepted the engagement, it will amount to removal, that is a different issue, and penalty procedures and my liability is also there. So we have to be very careful. Then, tomorrow client will put you in trouble, nothing else. If he knows the provision very well, then he will put into trouble. Why should we enter into trouble? So that let's understand, year after the mails will read like that only. We'll never say accounted. We'll say suggested method as per the accounting standard seems to be. Your accounting is like this, which will call for a qualification, like that you can put very well. And they can pass an entry to it. That is his prerogative or it is his choice. Then, design and implementation of financial information system, actual evaluation, investment advisory, investment banking, rendering outsourcing financial services, management services, others as may be prescribed. Management services is not defined. It is different in ICA. That ICA definition is not applicable to Companies Act under Section 144. This, where did they copy from? They have copied that from US regulation. Same order, A to I, it is there in US, same A to I here. There it is only applicable to listed company, public interest entity. You know that about India, they overdo everything. They have overdone here for private public company also. Now, as may be prescribed, nothing has been prescribed until now. Whether management services has been defined, no, they have not defined. Can I say tax preparing tax returns of a company is also a management service, because tax return is for the management, is for the company, and it has to be prepared by the company, but you are preparing. Can I say it is a prohibited services? So there is no clarity on this. ICA is actually given a draft representation of the Ministry of Corporate Affairs. Let's look into see when the definition is going to come out for management services. So management services, you said that in US, the same list is there. In US, what they did defined. In US, if you look at, there is something called International Ethical Standards Board of Accountants, ISBA. They have given the definition of management services. The US SEC listed, SEC has conveniently adopted the definition of management services, which clearly says tax returns should not be prepared by the practitioners. Can I adopt that regulation? We are looking at not adopting. But I don't know what representation has gone on, but there is a representation gone on for the definition of management services. Prohibited services cannot be provided either to the company or its holding company or a subsidiary company. If I provide for a holding company, also I cannot be the auditor of a subsidiary company. I cannot be the auditor of an associate company. If I am prohibited to provide if I am providing a prohibited services associate company, then I cannot be the auditor of a holding company. The entire structure, I cannot be the auditor. Still, directly or indirectly. Now, possible. For example, I am a practicing chartered accountant. I tell my friend to float a consultancy services. No, we are all friends. From today onwards, we are all friends. We all met together. I told somebody to float a consultancy firm. I have an audit in Kolkata. I tell my friend to float a consultancy service in Kolkata. And I, for all purpose, I am the boss. But nobody knows about it. So that is also covered through partners or parent or a subsidiary or associate entity in which the firm or any partner has significant influence. Significant influence. If you want to influence other firm, even if it is a friend's firm, he is prohibited and he is providing prohibited services and I cannot be the auditor. How will they find out significant?
How to prove?
How to prove? that all today, you're all here, we all have call and discussion tomorrow. That means, am I significantly influencing you? For a professional reason, we discuss in a CP meeting. That means, am I influencing you people? No. But it is considered to be a significant influence. These are all the issues which is there, which has to be diluted, which has to be diluted, which should be diluted. Then, ongoing prohibited services. Now, I have been rendering a non-prohibited services in the course of doing the audit. Until last year, it is fine. Until 31st March 2014, if you have provided non-audit services, provided audit services as well as prohibited services, no problem. But this year onwards, up to 30th June, they gave time to ensure that you resign out of the prohibited services or resign out of the audit. So, you have to do only one. Now, as a practitioner, how will you decide whether you wanted to be an auditor or a prohibited services? Let's go by the bottom line. As an auditor, you have a risk. Now, let us understand this way. You are auditing, risk is high. If the audit remuneration at least is very, very high, 10 times higher than the prohibited services, then take it up. Risk is high, you are doing audit, fees is also less, don't do it. Go for prohibited services. Prohibited services gives you prohibited services in total gives you 10 lakhs. Audit gives you 1.5 lakhs. Will you take up audit or prohibited services? Prohibited services. But again, a fresh member who is starting the practice, he will have a problem. He can say, I will provide all prohibited, but he needs a manpower. So in that perspective, then he should go only for audit services. 1.5 lakhs. Yearly work, he can do it alone, he can finish it off. But if it is a prohibited services, then it is a specialized services. Most of them are specialized services, which involves manpower. Then you have to evaluate based on these factors and the practitioners has to take a choice. Sir, is there a possibility I can do everything but bill it as per an audit? The client will not give you fees. You can do it without getting a letter. When you get a letter of engagement, only is issue. Orally, you do everything. Most of the time, you do that. And client, even though we are auditor for them, he will ask you only and pass tedious entry every month. He will call, sir, can I pass this entry, sir? Like that, he will ask you. For audit fees only, he will pay you. So looking at that perspective, these are all challenging issues which the practitioners face. Now, very interesting fact happened in the ministry. June 5th, initially, when the limit came in, the limit of 20 companies under the Companies Act included even your 1% company and small company. 1% company, what fees you will get, but it is counted for your 20 limit. So now, in June 5th, exemption notification, it has been taken away. 1% company, small company, if you are going to do the audit, it is not coming under the limit of 20. Now, not only that, the private limited company whose paid up share capital is 100 crores. 100. Listen, there is a problem that happened with the ministry. When the proposal happened, it was only 10 crores. It's a typo error. The ministry wrongly notified 100 crores. Is benefit or not benefit? Tell me one company in India, private limited company, which is having 100 crores paid up capital. One company. Paid up, that is, if a private limited company has 100 crores of paid up capital only, up to 100 crores it is exempt under 20 limit. It is actually 10 crores. If it is 10 crores, justifiable.
Have they rectified the mistake? No.
No, when we gave the representation, it is 10 crores only. Draft also had 10 crores only. Typo error.
Typographical.
It became benefit for us. But this benefit does not give so much benefit because ICA restricted 30 anyway. See, if you are having a 20 limit, let's assume ICA is not there, let's take it out. Then 20 limits they suggested. Private owned companies whose paid up capital up to 100 crores more only will be covered under 20 limit. Below 100 crores, whatever companies you have will be excluded from 20. Right? Show me one paid up company. Now, put it as very simply. Show me in Kolkata, what is one company which has a paid up capital of private owned company? 100 crores. One company. In India? Nowhere I can see. So, it's a typographical. 10 crores you have. It's a 10 crores only. Even if you look at the Companies Act, 10 crores only everywhere is written for the limits also. 10 crore or more. Same thing we applied. It's a typo error. And we are so much the governments are opposing on GST without even knowing what is GST is. Some of the people in the parliament, they don't know what is GST. Goods and service tax also they don't know. They know GST. Because everybody speaks GST. They keep opposing it because what benefit that will come to the country, they don't know. GST? No, we'll say. Opposition. that mind is already there. No, you should say no. When GST said, word GST said, even sleep if you make him get up, he'll say no. Like that, the mind is there. Nobody opposed in the parliament also. Nobody understands it. It is ourselves, for ourselves it is surprise. When we made the representation also, it is only 10 crores. And it came out, it is 100 crores. It happened to be benefit. If it is 1 crore, then we would have gone for a second representation. But in this case, we did not go. But anyway, it is not useful is what I say. Because, where ICI says, including your private limited company, 30 only. It does not talk about limit. Still, so 30 only is applicable, including where all companies put together, 30 only. That is there. So,
that is by the institute?
Institute only, for the members, equal opportunity for the members. So, individually this is beneficial. But now, institute if it wants to increase to 40, it can do that because the liberty is now there. But it, whether it will increase, it's a question mark because equal opportunity for members has to be protected. We should pray that it should not decrease because members are increasing. Yeah, so from that perspective, I'm telling you. But second thing can happen, more companies coming up, they can increase. Either of the two things should happen.
It's a small company. Government says a small company, then there is 100 crores.
Private limited company, 100 crores.
Small and private limited company.
Small is anyway excluded. Because company is having a paid-up capital of 100 crores can never be a small company. Neither OPC, it can never be OPC. Accordingly, it is only a private limited company. Accordingly, it is excluded. It was 10 crores which was supposed to be excluded. It is 100 crores. Now, more power has been given to ICI to either increase the audit or decrease the audit.
All the private companies of the country is below 100 crores. Of India.
Yes. So, that means there is no limit at all.
Rare. Very rare.
Very rare. Not rare also, it's not there.
It's not there.
Yeah.
The whole country
is
not fine.
So, today, who are the regulators? Who are our watchdogs? So, our watchdogs are SEBI. Listed company you do, everything is attracted. Income tax, SEBI. Okay. Listed company, which is a banking company, everything is attracted. RBI is your regulator. How many regulators were answerable? If you are doing a company, which is a banking company, it's regulated by RBI. RBI is your regulator. Then SEBI is your regulator, listed company, listed banking company. Second, third is your MCA.
NSE
and BSE. Yeah, NSE and BSE. Then fourth, your income tax. Under income tax, you have some more regulators who are much more powerful than income tax, your commissioners. When you go up with a representation to them, they'll keep saying, I'll refer the matter to the institute. Now is a trend in the income tax. I'll refer the matter to the institute. Like that they say to the members. Whatever you say, I'll refer the matter to the institute. Like that. Okay, so that is power, he is one of the regulator. Then you have your MCA, Ministry of Finance, that is nothing but income tax. Then you have your CBDT, CBEC, everyone. And then finally you have your local regulations, local pollution control, other regulations also follow. So primary your that is for the company, sorry. For your auditor is SEBI, RBI, your MCA, MOF, your Ministry of Finance, and then your ICI, and if NAFRA comes, NAFRA. So much. For our audit fees we get, we have to be answerable to so many. So that is the state of affairs, and that is how it is. 143.2 is that it says that you have to report to the members of the company the audit report. What are the changes in the audit report I have done? I have given everything in the PPT, you can look at it. In this PPT, how to draft an audit report. Now today, it is not a qualified report or unqualified report. Today, you have modified report and unmodified report. Unmodified report is nothing but a clean report, as per SAS 700. What is SAS 700? Is Standards on Auditing 700. Today, the format of the audit report is given under SAS 700. The requirement, the statutory requirement is given under your Companies Act. So, when you are drafting an audit report, you should take SA 700 plus the requirements of the Companies Act. What is this SA 700? Simple. India, we don't do anything new. We will only take the best practices. It was an ISA 700 in other parts of the world. You should buy the IFAC. We took cut I and then we say SA 700. The format of the international is also there here. In the international format, we fit our format. That is nothing but Companies Act. So, what does your audit report contain? Paras. To the independent auditor's report to the members of the company, responsibility of the management. We know what is the responsibility of the management. Theoretically, responsibility of the auditor. Then, opinion paragraph. Then, you have your reporting on other legal and regulatory requirements under which you have Companies Act requirement. Then you have emphasis of matter paragraph, then other matter paragraph, then signature of the auditor. Under reporting on other regulatory requirements, you have your CARO 143 subsection 12, subsection 11 that has to be reported. So two annexures will be there going forward. One is an annexure on CARO which is coming. Next is an annexure that is going to be there for IFC, Internal Financial Control, as per section 143, subsection 3, clause I, in the next year. This year it is exempted. So structure goes like this, to repeat again, to independent auditors report to the members of the company, responsibility of the management, responsibility of the auditor, then third is where opinion paragraph, that is opinion paragraph, and then reporting on other legal and regulatory requirements under which CARO will come, and then you have your emphasis of matter paragraph and other matter paragraph. SA 700 talks about clean report. SA 705 talks about modified report. Unmodified report is SA 700, modified report is SA 705, and emphasis of matter paragraph is SA 706. Now I will give a brief about it and conclude the session. Rest of the things are format which you can look at it in my PPT. I have given everything. In SA 705, we have three factors based on which a modification is attracted. One is your materiality. One is your materiality. Second is your pervasiveness. Third is well, sufficient appropriate audit evidence. Three factors, we call it as MPS. MP, let us remember, member of parliaments, like that we can remember. Materiality, pervasiveness and sufficient appropriate audit evidence. What is material, what is not material will not call for any modification. It is not material, but pervasive and sufficient appropriate audit evidence is not there. In both these cases, it will not call for modification. When it will call for modification is, the primary condition should be a material amount. It should be a material amount. And pervasive. What is my pervasive is, if one account is affected, another account is affected. For example, sales is affected, closing stock is affected. When the closing stock is affected, next year opening stock is affected. So pervasive, the continuous effect is there. Accordingly, that is pervasive. Sufficient appropriate audit evidence is nothing, but evidence is there for that materiality and pervasiveness. So if it is material, and not pervasive, and you have sufficient appropriate audit evidence, you will issue a qualified report. In qualified report, what you state is, except for that item, other items show you true and fair. Then adverse opinion, it is material, it is pervasive. You have sufficient appropriate audit evidence to say it is material and pervasive, then you issue an adverse opinion or negative opinion. Then disclaimer of opinion, it is material, it is pervasive, but you don't have any evidence, accounting system crashed, all invoices, vouchers, lost, like the client says, nothing you can able to draw opinion, no evidence at all, then in that situation, disclaimer of opinion has to be given. The advice to the practitioners, when you are giving a disclaimer of opinion, ensure that you don't give it, you resign out of the client. Yes, sir.
I know one case where a legal case is pending and it is very material. If the decision comes, it will have an impact on the person. But the auditor says, no legal case is pending. What shall you do now?
It is an issue, it's a misconduct. I'll tell you how. When a legal matter is pending,
whom shall I report?
Yeah, I'll tell you how. The process of how do you conclude the issue. When the legal matter is pending, it is the responsibility of the auditor to obtain the audit evidence for the legal evidence, legal matter. As per SA 501, there is a specific matter that has been specific items, audit evidence with a specific consideration. Under the litigation is there. For the litigation, auditor should obtain an opinion from the external person. Or he can obtain on his own if he is really wanted to do, or he can make the management to obtain. If he makes the management to obtain, he should rely on the work of experts. For that, there is SA 2620 which has to be relied upon. So by looking at the expert, who is called an expert? By looking at the opinion, by looking at his experience, by looking at his expertise, name in the society, you can conclude that he's an expert. After that, you should understand as a common man whether whatever he has given is right. Like this, the procedure should be followed. Looking at that, you should estimate whether provision has to be made as per AS 29. Because the litigation is always a contingent liability. It's a may or may not. It is an off-balance sheet item. It need not be accounted in the books of accounts. When do you account is? When it's going to become sure, or it's going to crystallize as a liability.
Pending? You should say that this is pending.
No, let us understand. So this is a crystallization, you will check first. When the crystallization is not there, when there is a remote chance only, it is a pending amount. When it is a pending amount, your CARO disputed, disputes. If the stats to reduce, disputed stats reduce, disputed matters, it's with respect to statutory matter, then you will disclose as per CARO. If it is not disclosed as per CARO, then the pending matter has to be disclosed by the management in the notes to accounts. If the management does not disclose the pending litigation in the notes to accounts, then you need to take up a choice whether to give an other matter paragraph. But it will not attract disqualification. When it will attract qualification is, modified report is, when the litigation is there, when you conclude it, provision should be made. But the management does not make a provision, then that means your financial statement is not stated properly. Then it is affecting true and fair view. But here, still it is pending. You are not able to conclude whether it will materialize. Then it has to be disclosed as per notes to accounts. Then if the management is disclosing the notes to accounts, either if you want to highlight to the users, you can give us an emphasis matter paragraph. You can emphasize in your audit report. If the management is not providing notes to accounts, you can straight away provide another matter paragraph stating that the management has not disclosed.
But you cannot say the both case pending.
No, you cannot say. That is a misconduct.
That is misconduct.
A deliberate negligence. Not negligence. You are in hand and glove with the management. When there is a matter pending, you have to disclose why a matter is pending. At least if you are silent, then it will act. Not a gross negligence, you can protect yourself. But there is a matter pending or deliberately you are saying, that itself shows that you are hand in glove with the management. Like that the procedure goes. So all these I say 700, 705 and 706 is incorporated with the company audit report.
But your disciplinary committee does not take any action.
I don't know whether they
I think you can.
Oh.
Maybe you are not following these things.
Okay.
I'm very sorry,
So this is the total provisions. I've tried to capture every aspect of audit report. I've given everything. Every aspect is covered. Search question is also covered. CARO is also covered. CARO today has 12 clauses only. You can look at it. Formats are also given. NAFRA provisions are also covered. Totally 125 slides. It's printed, which you can look at it. So there are certain issues where I want to discuss about related party and all. We are running short of time. Definitely sometime later we'll catch up here. Related party, deposit, loan from directors and everything. And then we'll discuss at that point of time in the larger crowd. And thank you so much for EIRC of ICI and all the officials of the ICI, the chairman of the EIRC of ICI, Mr. Pramod Ruptaji, who has recommended my name for a presentation today. And thank you so much for the opportunity. Thank you so much for the members. I'm only a speaker, not because I'm knowledgeable. I carry the knowledge of the senior member. I carry the quest of the junior members who may coach every day, students. Because of that, I am a speaker. That's all. I am only a messenger. Your experience I am going to tell in other brands. That's about it. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity. We'll look forward for meeting in some point of time. Thank you so much.